Hello everyone, and welcome back to our Quest and Dialog system in Godot 4 and GDScript. In this video, we will set up our player's interaction with our NPC and quest item. To do this, we will use the raycast node that we previously added to check whether or not our player is interacting with an object in the NPC group or an object in the item group. If we are interacting with an object from the NPC group, we will start our dialogue. And if we are interacting with an object from the item group, we will check if that item is needed for an active quest, and if it is, we will pick it up, and if it isn't, we will just leave it be. Okay, so let's open up our project. Before we continue, we will need to add a new input action that will fire off these events, because we don't just want our player to immediately pick up an item or start a dialogue once they focus on an NPC or a quest item.
But you know where I can find it.
So, if our player is looking at these entities and they press a certain key, then only will they start talking to the NPC or try and pick up the quest item. Let's create a new input called UI underscore interact, and we'll assign the E key on our keyboard to this action. Okay. So now we'll get started by checking for interactions with our NPC. Since we don't have our quest or dialogue system set up yet, we will test our interactions with a simple print statement. So, in our NPC script, let's create a new function which will start our dialogue. This will contain a print statement that should be logged to the console if our player interacts with our NPC. We can now go back to our player script and use our raycast and input action that we just created to start this dialogue. We will also have to create a new variable that will determine whether or not our player can move around when interacting, because the last thing we want is for our player to be able to talk to our NPC but also run around at the same time whilst they're trying to have a conversation. you'll see that our raycast is determining whether or not we are talking to an NPC via the NPC group. And if we are talking to an entity in that group, then we will call their start dialog function that we just created. I also commented set can move to false because later on we'll have to stop our player from moving around, and we'll do this by setting the can move variable to false. But currently we have no way of undoing that action, so whenever we end the dialogue we'll allow our player to move again, but because we don't have our dialogue system we can't do that, so we'll implement these changes later on. Let's start our scene and start interacting with our NPC by looking at them and pressing our E key on our keyboard. You should see that in the output console, our print statements on both our player and NPC side are executing. And now our player can interact with our NPC. Now let's do the same for our quest item. In our quest item script, let's create a new function which will print a statement if our player is interacting with the item. And then in our player script, we can do the same as we did for our NPC group, but just for our items group. You'll see that once again, we are using our raycast to check if we are interacting with an item in the items group. And then I added a bunch of to-do statements, which will tell us what to do later on, once we actually have our quest system. So we'll check if the item that we are interacting with is needed for a quest, and if it is, we'll remove the item. But for now, we're just going to print as we interact with them. Now, if you run your scene and you interact with an object or an item, your print statement should be logged to the console. And there you have it, the base for our simple interaction system. As we build our system, we won't just be printing statements as we interact with the world, but this gives us a good foundation to build on. In the next part, we will tackle the UI creation of our dialogue and quest system. But for now, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.